In the Angular CDK, there are a lot of cool, exciting, and helpful features. And the overlay module is one of the most powerful. It's used to create things like dialogs, tooltips, menus, custom dropdowns, and more. Now, I've already created a couple of videos on the overlay module, one where I cover the basics of setting them up, and another where I demonstrate different ways that they can be positioned within the viewport. If you're unfamiliar with these concepts and haven't watched those videos, you should do that before watching this one because we will build off the examples that we created in them. Here, we'll be focused on how we want an overlay to react when scrolling the container it's positioned within. The overlay module provides us with four scrolling behaviors out of the box: reposition, block, close, and no op. In this video, we'll take a close look at each one. All right, let's get to it. One of the core concepts that we learned about in the overlay basics video is that the physical markup for the overlay is injected at the end of the document just before the closing body tag. And this is what makes it so useful. This means that it can always be placed above any other content and is not constrained in any way by the containers that wrap the origin element. But the fact that it's detached from the thing that we are positioning it in relation to is actually problematic in some ways. Handling scroll is one of those problematic scenarios. If the markup was injected near the origin element, then we wouldn't need to do anything on scroll. It would just scroll along with the origin. But there's lots of issues with that too, which is why we need the overlay. Good news for us, we have several different options to handle scrolling. We can use any one of four what are known as scroll strategies provided in the overlay module. We can even create our own custom strategy if we want, but that's a topic for another video. The first strategy we'll be looking at will be the reposition strategy. With this position strategy, the pop-up gets repositioned as its parent scrolling container is scrolled. It makes it appear as if the markup is physically placed near its origin in the DOM. Okay, so here's the demo project we've been working on in the last few videos with the overlay module. We have this list of notable NBA players, and they each have a button that triggers a pop-up that we created using the CDK Connected Overlay directive. Now, before we can configure a position strategy for this pop-up, we need to first inject in the overlay service within our constructor. Now we can create a property called scrollStrategy. We'll set this property to a provided scroll strategy from the overlay service, and then we'll use it via an input on our CDK connected overlay in the template. Okay, to set this scroll strategy, we need to add this.overlay.scrollStrategies, and then we can use the reposition strategy function. And now we can pass it to the directive in the template. To do this, we use the CDK connected overlay scroll strategy input. And we simply pass it our scroll strategy property. After we save, we can open up a pop-up. And then as we scroll, we can see that it scrolls along with the origin. Pretty crazy because the overlay has to actually recalculate its positioning while scrolling, but it's surprisingly performant. Now, the reposition strategy is actually the default behavior for this directive. So if this is what we want, we don't need to pass a strategy to the directive at all. Here, I've removed it and it's still being repositioned as we scroll. So just keep that in mind. Okay, up next, we're going to look at the block strategy. This strategy will actually prevent us from scrolling the container while the pop-up is open. So now that we have everything set up, to change to another strategy is really simple. But first, we need to add back our input. Then we just need to switch from the reposition method to the block method instead. Now, when we save, open the pop-up, and try to scroll, nothing happens. Probably a little tough to tell on your end, but I'm actually using my mouse wheel to attempt to scroll up and down in this container, but nothing's happening. So that's another option. Next up, we'll look at the close strategy. This one's pretty self-explanatory, but just in case it's not clear, this strategy will close the overlay when scrolling. To use it, we simply need to replace the block method with the close method instead. There, now when we scroll, the pop-up is closed. Now last up, we have the no-op strategy. This strategy just doesn't do anything when we scroll. It doesn't reposition, block, or close. Instead, it does nothing. Once again, let's replace the close method with the no-op this time. There, now as we scroll, we can see nothing happens. Okay, so there's all the built-in scroll strategies, but there's one more important aspect when it comes to connected overlays and scrolling. It has to do with the scrolling container itself. Right now, our scrolling container is our root element, the HTML element. If we were to move the overflow styles off of the HTML element to an element within our app component instead, and then if we switch back to use the reposition scroll strategy and then save, when we open our pop-up and scroll, we can see that the pop-up is no longer repositioning to keep itself attached to the origin. It's almost like we're using the no-op strategy that we just learned about, but we're not. This is because we need to let the overlay know that our scrolling container is actually a different element now. By default, if we don't explicitly specify the scrolling container, it will fall back to the root element. In many cases, this won't work. More good news though, this is pretty easy to do. We need to first import the cdkScrollable class in the component where our new scrolling container lives. In this example, it's within our app component. Now, in the template, we can add the cdkScrollable directive on the scrolling container itself, which is this section element. And now, the overlay will use this for its scrolling context. So when we open it up again and scroll, it's correctly getting repositioned again. All right, so now you have several different ways to handle pop-ups and scrolling. Stay tuned for more videos on the overlay module in the future. That's all for now. Until next time, thanks for watching.